One last thing before we actually go to eat apps. Yes. And that is the concept of converting a multiple degree of freedom system into an equivalent single degree of freedom system. That concept is also associated with the use of pushover analysis. Let's say that you have a full three-dimensional nonlinear multiple degree of freedom system model, and you apply some load pattern and push that building and plot the pushover curve, which is this one. So you already have the base shear versus roof displacement curve for your building. Now, what you can additionally do with this pushover curve is that you convert that pushover curve into the force deformation curve, because it has VB, which is some force on y-axis, and roof displacement, which is displacement on x-axis. If this curve is idealized into a force deformation curve by a few points, for example, yield point, ultimate point, last point, you idealize by some trilinear curve, for example, and assign this curve as a force deformation behavior to a single degree of freedom system. Because single degree of freedom system, the elastic single degree of freedom system will have a constant K value. An inelastic single degree of freedom system, instead of having a constant K value, it will have a complete force versus deformation curve as an input, right? So instead of giving any force deformation behavior, if we give this particular force deformation behavior to a particular single degree of freedom system, that single degree of freedom system will start behaving dynamically like that multiple degree of freedom system, because its global behavior is mapped to a single degree of freedom system through pushover curve. So that single degree of freedom system, which is having this force deformation behavior as an input, that single degree of freedom system will start representing your multiple degree of freedom system. If you perform any analysis to this single degree of freedom system, the result will be same as if you perform the analysis for that multiple degree of freedom system. So there is a concept called converting a nonlinear multiple degree of freedom system into an equivalent nonlinear single degree of freedom system, right? But the issue is that if your building is controlled by first mode only, if it is dominated by first mode only, you can push your building in first mode pattern, and the resulting pushover curve can be given as an input to your single degree of freedom system. Then that single degree of freedom system will represent your first mode only, first mode of your multiple degree of freedom system. If your building is dominated by more than one modes, then you cannot have just one single degree of freedom system for that building. You may have to have more than one single degree of freedom systems. So I give you a specific example for this case, that let's say that I have a detailed multiple degree of freedom system, and I perform the cyclic pushover analysis, and I get the cyclic pushover curve. I can convert that actually into a force deformation behavior. So the base shear can be converted into a force, idealized force, and roof drift is converted into a displacement. So that whole behavior is converted into a force deformation behavior, and that force deformation behavior can be given as an input to one single degree of freedom system. So that single degree of freedom system now will start behaving or start representing that multiple degree of freedom system, because it is given the input same as the global behavior of that multiple degree of freedom system. So you can say that the global behavior, the lateral cyclic behavior of a multiple degree of freedom system is mapped to a single degree of freedom system. So now it is acting like one particular mode of that building, that mode for which the behavior is mapped to this single degree of freedom system. So if you now can analyze this single degree of freedom system, you can actually reduce your computational effort. Instead of analyzing your detailed model, you can convert it into a single degree of freedom system and analyze that system and convert the results back to the same multiple degree of freedom system. This is the same example that actually you first perform the pushover analysis. Let's say this is the monotonic pushover curve, and then this curve is joined with some hysteretic rule that how the loading should be, how the stiffness should behave in unloading, and then how it should behave in reloading. Some hysteretic rule is combined with the backbone curve, and then it is given as an input to our equivalent single degree of freedom system, equivalent non-linear single degree of freedom system. So one obvious way of determining the target displacement is to run this single degree of freedom system against the future ground shaking and get the peak displacement, and that will be your target displacement. So this is also one method to determine target displacement, or you can say performance point, that you convert approximately your multiple degree of freedom system into an equivalent single degree of freedom system, and then run the ground shaking for that particular single degree of freedom system. And the peak response against that ground shaking will be your target displacement. Now go back to your pushover analysis, and at that target displacement, extract all the responses. So I'll be discussing several methods to determine target displacement or performance point. But one of that method is this one, the nonlinear time history analysis of equivalent single degree of freedom system.